Students, you know that inside our body, blood is present. Blood is a transporting medium. But it is not just a fluid, it is connective tissue. It is slightly alkaline with pH 7.4, salty in taste. Actually, in blood, there is a fluid called plasma and blood cells are floated in plasma. Now, imagine a situation where floating blood cells are separated from blood. Then the colorless or pale yellow or thick fluid left behind is plasma. Part of plasma is water in which many materials are present in dissolved form. Among the variety of components, there are inorganic salts, proteins like albumin, globulin, fibrinogen, prothrombin, gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide, nutrient molecules formed after food digestion. Also, there are water molecules. Suspended in plasma are three major types of blood cells, namely red blood cells or RBCs or erythrocytes, white blood cells WBCs or leukocytes, and blood platelets or thrombocytes. Red blood cells or erythrocytes. These are rounded or circular cell without nucleus. Our blood is dark red in color because of RBCs. RBCs are present in large number in blood, that is 50 to 60 lakh cells in 1 cubic millimeter of blood. RBCs are produced in red bone marrow and live for about 100 to 120 days. White blood cells or leukocytes. In comparison with RBCs, WBCs are only 5000 to 10000 cells in 1 cubic millimeter of blood. Those cells are large but do not have fixed shape. They have nucleus. These types are based on shape of nucleus and nature of cytoplasm. Sometimes there is increase in the number of WBCs due to pathological reasons. This is called leukemia or blood cancer. Blood platelets or thrombocytes. These are very small disc-shaped cells. Usually 2.5 to 4 lakh cells are present in 1 cubic millimeter of blood. But sometimes the count of platelets from blood may decrease drastically. This may happen if persons suffer from infections like malaria, dengue. Thus, all the blood cells are playing important functions in our body. Apart from this, it performs many other functions like transport of oxygen to all cells, supply of nutrients to cells, fight with germs by producing antibodies. Blood transports hormones and enzymes to their destination organs. Blood maintains temperature of our body at 37 degrees Celsius. So, after studying blood composition and functions of blood, you will realize that life of a person could be in danger if he loses lot of blood from his body. Summary. Today you have studied components of blood and their role in our body. All the blood cells are playing important functions in our body.
WBCs are our bodyguards and fight with microbes which cause infections.